2002 to 2005 was a big time for new generation superhero video games. We got Spider-Man 1, the much improved Spider-Man 2, Superman Returns, some X-Men games, and a few others. Today I want to take a closer look at 2003's Hulk, which is a direct follow-up to the 2003 Ang Lee movie, which has been widely criticized as not a good movie. The video game, though, has generally positive reviews. This is one of the first few games I ever had as a kid, and I remember really liking it. I went to my local game shop and decided to buy it and play through again, and just see how much was nostalgia, and how much of it was actually good. I'm not quite as attached to the Hulk as I am to, say, Spider-Man, so I was able to be pretty objective, I think. Story. The game takes place roughly 8 years after the film. Bruce Banner has been led to believe by Dr. Crawford that he's developed a cure for the Hulk called the Gamma Orb. He was tricked by Dr. Crawford, however, to use the orb's power to transform into a Hulk-like creature himself. The progression now is for Hulk to stop Dr. Crawford and General Riker from using the Hulk's power for evil purposes. The story serves well to introduce Hulk villains that you may be otherwise unfamiliar with, like Half-Life, Madman, and the Leader. It also gives Banner a real motive for attempting to stop General Riker from using the Hulk's power, namely killing hostages and threatening Betty Ross because she wouldn't aid the military. Overall, I think the story is pretty decent and it serves the game's progression well. Gameplay. The game starts you off strong as the Hulk in a dream sequence. It's meant to get the ball rolling early and let you adapt to the Hulk's skills and abilities. It's also a lot of fun learning the range of what the Hulk can actually do, like grab people and throw them, and the sonic clap. What becomes apparent as the game progresses is that there isn't much variation from Hulk's attacks. You can change it up some, but it's mostly just a 1-2-3 punch. You can fill your rage meter and do a special move, which happens fairly frequently. My big criticism about this is that you have no choice of when to use it. Once the bar is filled, he's going into rage mode. You can't choose when to activate it, like when a large group of enemies approaches you. Sometimes you would have just killed the final enemy in a group of enemies, and the rage meter just then activates, which can be very frustrating. Another aspect to the gameplay is actually playing as Bruce Banner. As a kid, I remember almost enjoying these missions more than the Hulk ones. Most of the missions where you play as Bruce are stealth missions. They weren't entirely challenging now, since the game is pretty linear. It's hard to get really lost, except for maybe a few levels if you tried. True to stealth missions, if you get spotted, you really won't be able to take down your attacker. I was successful fighting one-on-one later in the game, but if more than one come after you, it's best to just run away. The camera became a bit annoying for me at several parts, mostly when you're trying to get somewhere. If you're running, the camera will automatically shift to a new perspective, making you adjust the perspective on the joystick. This is also problematic trying to fight people. As Bruce Banner, you can't freely move the camera to see any surrounding enemies or where they are. You have to physically move to another camera perspective. There were some glitches as well. When I entered rage mode near the end of one of the last levels, it caused the game to freeze once the final cutscene happened. I had to restart my Xbox and play through the entire level again. Boss fights. Overall, the boss fights were pretty enjoyable without being entirely overwhelming. Half-Life, for example, requires you to use the environment around you to defeat him, since touching him drains your life. Ravage and Madman were pretty much the same, just keep punching them and avoid some falling debris sometimes. The battle with Flux is when the boss fights become slightly more challenging. When you fight him, you must destroy these terminals before throwing him into this huge energy wall. You have to do this while avoiding his projectile grenades and him just generally trying to hurt you, all with limited health and few regeneration orbs, and you have to do it several times. The final boss did end up being very challenging. Like with most of the bosses, once you deplete their health, they fully regenerate and you have to beat them again. I was able to defeat the final boss by hiding in this corner against an elevator and just letting him float to me. It also protected me from his laser blast that he would shoot. Overall, the game is worth a playthrough, despite some technical issues. The pace moves quickly without anything feeling rushed, and the levels are unique enough in their design and missions to keep you engaged. The simplicity of the Hulk's moves leaves some to be desired, but it's not significant enough to ruin an otherwise really fun game. There's also some cheats that I didn't really go super in detail with, but you could play as like the Gray Hulk and he has some really funny one-liners and a couple of other cheat codes.
I need to find a bigger opponent.
Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know what you thought about the Hulk if you remember playing it. Make sure to like and subscribe for more fun content. And as always, I appreciate you watching and I'll catch you in my next video. Take care.